Welcome to RadiCards.com. I'm your host, Patrick. This is Dan Grinnell, SportsSecurities.com.
How's it going?
So, Dan, you came. It's been a while since you have been here.
Yeah, you know, holidays, family events, and I got sick for a while, and then, you know, just things.
Yeah, life happens.
Life happens.
Sure. And so you're gonna talk about something a little bit different today. Share with us what you have here.
So I brought a couple of cards, and then I brought a set, and this set is it's interesting. A few years ago, I was cruising blowoutcards.com, mm-hmm. and actually, I had read about it on, you know, maybe it was Chris Olds had written about it, or he had blogged about it or something, and he was talking about what a great deal the 2009 8 seconds by Press Pass cases were. And so I kind of checked it out, and on blowout cards, they had cases of PBR cards, so that's professional bull riding, for minimal cost. I mean, I think it was like $50 for a case of cards.
Wow.
So I decided, you know what?
Hot product.
It's cardboard. It's a sport. It's actually kind of a cool sport if you ever watched the pro bull riders. And I said, why not? I'll pop on it.
You know, the only time I've ever seen bull riding happen is on Pee-wee's Big Adventure.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Yeah,
that was a good scene. We have a lot of people here that are in the
I have missed
riding.
That entire
this is
category.
Part of the PBR circuit. As a matter of fact, I just
Pat's Blue Ribbon.
Yeah. But anyhow, this is a complete set of PBR cards, and I brought this for you. I thought you might be something fun to look at and show people, maybe blog about. We're definitely going to talk about it. And so this one is for you.
Thank you.
But what I think is cool about this set is that it has all the different riders, so you can kind of flip through there and see some of the more popular ones. Ty Murray, I mean, he's a household name in bull riding.
Is he?
Yeah, and what's cool about these cards
is that, rookie card?
Is that it talks a little bit about them and who they are, where they're from. I know there's a guy in here from New Mexico. I can't remember what his name is. There's some Brazilians. Apparently, that's big down there with the Gauchos. You know, but what I think is kind of cool is some of these cards, like take for example this guy, I can't pronounce his name, he must be Brazilian, looks like it's Guilherme Marchi. It not only shows his picture, but on the back he talks about his injuries, right, as a professional bull rider. So he's had a broken rib, he's had sprained right elbow, he's had sprained left ankle, separated left knee, right, pulled groin, and a broken left second toe.
And then after that, he'll list all the injuries he's gotten bull riding.
Right. The rider's part.
This guy's name is Tater Porter.
They show some of the bullfighters or the rodeo clowns, which apparently they're a pretty big deal as well. They're the ones that go in and save everybody from the mad bull. But my favorite part of the set is that it actually has cards for the bulls.
Finally, a card set for the bulls.
For the bulls. And you can learn all about the big bulls. Like, we've got Black Pearl. He's pretty cool.
This one's good.
One of my favorites.
Booger Butt.
One of my favorites, Blueberry Wine. He was a mean bull. I think he is retired for a while. Booger Butt, yeah.
Chicken on a Chain. It's like a meal.
You know, Little Yellow Jacket, Mossy Oak Mudslinger. That bull, I think he stomped a lot of cowboy face in his lifetime. I remember seeing him a few times, and he was mean. He was a mean bull. So, you know, Pat, it's not definite. It's definitely not the normal cardboard, but it is fun. It is funny.
Are there inserts in this?
There are.
Like autographs, or
there were,
own a piece of the bull.
There were autographs.
You know?
There were piece of the bull riders, you know, like flannel or rodeo shirt. I don't know what they call it. You know, you could have gotten, you know, one or the other in the box. Really, the most noteworthy one in the set was the Ty Murray autograph. I think you can pick that up on eBay anywhere from $50 to $70. You know?
Really?
You might be able to find it cheaper now. He's kind of been
Well, thank you for the two sets, my friend. Sure thing. That's really nice.
If you want more, I probably got like 10 or 15 others, so let me know. Let me know.
That sounds great.
So the other thing is more in line with what we normally do. I brought a couple of cards. Both of them are Steph Curry rookie cards. So the first one I brought is the Steph Curry Tops, and I believe it is the gold version, numbered to 2009. So that one's pretty cool.
That is cool.
And there, ooh, just dropped it. And there's the back. You can kind of see the numbering on there. And funny thing is I knew I had these for a while, and so I was looking up this one, thinking that this was the one that I had that was most valuable, and I came across this one, and for some reason, I could not figure out why I couldn't find it. And then it dawned on me that it's the Topps Chrome and not the regular Topps, which is, you know, a rookie mistake, but I was making it. And so I've got...
And you're a veteran.
Yeah, you know, for the life of me, I probably spent 10 minutes trying to figure this out, and then I was like, dang it. Right, and then I was like, that's what it is. It's the Topps Chrome.
Is that the stronger of the two?
So of the two, this is the stronger one right now. And you can see that one's got a different serial number there. That one is 999.
And the other one is 2000.
This one's 2009. And this is the, like I said, I think this is the gold version.
Mm-hmm. It is the gold.
Of the regular one.
You can always tell because of the gold border, and it'll always be stamped serial number to the year.
Yeah.
So... 2010 Topps, it'll be stamped to 2010, 2011 Topps, 2011.
So anyways, they're pretty cool. You know, funny thing is I bought these with the intent on selling them, and I put them in a box, and at the time Steph Curry was popular, but he wasn't what he is now. And about, you know, I want to say maybe 6 months ago, I was going through the box, and I came across them, and I was like, oh my gosh, did not realize, you know, I had them until I found them again, and then I was like, wow, I can't believe I've been sitting on these. And
are you going to move them?
I had no clue. No, you know, I probably am not.
You haven't graded or anything?
I was thinking about the Topps Chrome. The centering on it looks pretty good thrown in there.
Good stuff, man. Yeah. I've seen a lot of that card over the last year. I've probably seen 50 to 100 copies of the base Topps just in a stack.
Yeah.
Guys that bought collections and... The collections were, you know, created around this time, and they didn't know what they had, so they just sold all the boxes to this one fellow friend of mine. He opens up the box, there's several boxes, a stack of 5,000 counts, mm-hmm. and he pulled out a stack of the Stephon Curry. It's just unbelievable.
Well, I'm kicking myself a little bit because back in the day I had one of his playoff contenders rookies I bought actually at the National from some guy, and it came in a stack of cards. I think I bought everything for $35. And I sold it on eBay for probably like 60 or something, and now I'm like, that kind of would have been a nice card to have.
We don't know. I mean, hindsight's 20/20. Yeah. So yeah. I mean, even the guys that, you know, like, you know, Trout wasn't, you know, touted at all, and he came up to be a mega star.
Yeah.
And so now people are going after stuff they should have been chasing in 2009 and 10.
Right.
And
you know, paying through the nose for it.
They're paying through the nose for that Bowman Chrome Draft Orange Refractor number to 25 or whatever. So. Yeah, I mean, nobody really knows what's going to happen. You have to kind of just take as a gamble.
That is true, and usually that's not the gamble I'm willing to take. I go with.
I don't blame you. I'm right there with you. So, thank you for sharing.
Sure.
These are really fascinating. I will start with a card I bought. It's three autographs in this card. And I bought this. You know, a lot of guys do this. I sometimes am guilty of it, but, you know, when someone passes away, you try to find one of their cards that you'd just like just to have as a remembrance of a life gone by that we once enjoyed either watching or seeing in baseball card packs or whatever else. And Dave Henderson recently passed away, and so I wanted to get something from him, and so I bought his rookie card, the only rookie card that he ever had. This is a time when only one rookie card existed for a certain player. I really kind of missed that. I think today it's overdone and it's confusing and people don't know what's a rookie card and what's not. And so this is his only rookie card, and it's signed by all three players. 82 Topps, Dave Adler, Dave Henderson, or Reggie Walton. I thought this was a cool addition. I'll probably have this PSA authenticated just to have in a nice case at some point in the future. Not really running to that situation right now, but it'll eventually find itself in a PSA case.
Can I take a look at it?
Yeah. So, you know, I when I was younger, I was always like, oh, Dave Henderson, another Henderson. Maybe he's related to Ricky Henderson.
Right.
I really don't know if they're related, but, you know, this is kind of a nice addition. And I remember seeing him with the sideburns, not sideburns, with the mutton chops.
Yeah.
You know, in the 80s.
82 Tops. Yeah. It was a good year. I liked that set.
Good stuff. And he wasn't even in the traded set.
Right.
So, it's kind of a nice
and
piece.
The Mariners and their old...
their old Star
Trident,
logo.
Their old Trident logo there. Yeah. Really cool.
Yeah. The next one is a... I found this because in 2003, Donruss Elite did the Aspirations base and gold and then the Status base and gold parallels. And the Aspirations, the gold parallel to Aspirations is actually, it's a one-of-one set.
Wow.
And I picked this up because, I just thought it was affordable. It was, you know, very, very affordable for what it was and such a beautiful set. This is the Torii Hunter from that set. It's got that nice, classic... status slash aspirations refractor finish that was you started to see around this time. I just think these cards are really sweet. I love the die cut. I just think the die cut is so rad. You don't see stuff like this as much anymore. And I think this was around the time when this kind of design was starting to be produced in a less and less scale. And I really can still appreciate it to this day. I just think it's a great looking set.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of die cut.
Oh, they're fantastic.
Huge fan of die cut.
So I picked that up. It'd be a nice addition. I sometimes, as a side project to my Frank Thomas addiction, is that I collect one of ones, but I'm really picky. I don't buy them all the time. It's very rare. And when I do, they have to have some kind of a significance. For this one, it's the set. I love 2003 Donruss Elite. I think these cards are beautiful.
It's 03, right?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. And, Torii Hunter was on the Angels for a while, and I lived in Fullerton for a little while next to Anaheim, and he was on the Angels during that time. So it kind of has like a remembrance sort of factor to me, and it was under $20.
How many gold gloves did he win?
You know, I don't know offhand.
I think it's a lot.
But he was a solid player.
He was a solid player. That's a nice one.
Yeah. That concludes this episode. Thank you for watching RadiCards.com. Until next time, enjoy collecting.
Take care.